Bums. Welcome back to our channel, Bruce Bums.
So for the ones who have stumbled upon this video just now, we are a couple who love to travel all over India on our motorcycle. So Bruce Bums is our travel page. Please do check out our Facebook and Instagram as well. And follow, share and subscribe. And this is going to be our 10 days, 10 cities budget video.
So pause if you haven't seen any of our vlogs. First, I would request you all to just go back to our videos page and see all of our vlogs. We have seen some phenomenal cities all over India, and yes, we did it in 10 days. Check out all of our videos and then come back to the budget video so that you can plan your next trip.
Yeah. So after we finished our 10 days and 10 cities tour, we posted a lot of random photos and videos on Instagram and Facebook. The response was so amazing. So thank you all for that.
Yes, thank you.
So first of all, we want to let you know that this video is, I mean, the entire 10 days, 10 cities tour was in no way sponsored by any brand. This was our own saved money. So budget was the utmost priority for us. And this was on our list for a very long time. So it was like, it's now or never.
Yes. So the most frequently asked question was, what was your magic number? Kitna kharcha kiya apne? You must have easily spent about a lakh, 50,000, 75,000. 10 days, 10 cities, and all these 10 cities were, you could say, popular tourism wise. So everybody was very, very keen on understanding. And the magic number that we arrived on was only 42,000 rupees.
42,000.
Which included petrol, activities, stay, and food, of course, all of that. And just 42,000 rupees. And in no way we did not indulge or miss out on an experience. We did everything everywhere in all these 10 cities.
So just 42,000, let's get straight to it. We want to break it into four parts. So it's going to be petrol, stay, food and miscellaneous.
Yes, so coming to the two major expenses that we had throughout this trip was stay and petrol. Obviously we can't really say what is more important. It all goes hand in hand. So we have an Excel sheet which has a complete breakup of day wise where all we went, talking about these four types of expenses that we had. Not to bore you with a lot of, you could say, financials or talking about it, but I would just say that there were a few things that worked in our favor. One major part of it was that we did it on a motorcycle. So our petrol expense was just somewhere around 9,600 rupees for almost 3,000 kilometers that we did. And we rode on our Domina 400, which gave me a fluctuating mileage of 26 to 28 kilometers per liter. And I think that was pretty okay and convenient. The most important factor is convenient. We could travel wherever we wanted. We were not restricted in any way. So yeah, if you're traveling in any of these cities and you have your own vehicle, I think that's definitely a plus point. Secondly, coming to the stay part. So when it came to the stay part, of course, we were staying in certain cities which were only a one night engagement. So we did not really want to cross a threshold that we had kept for us internally. Looking at the fact that there was COVID, a lot of offers going on. And of course, you have Airbnbs as well as OYOs, which are decent properties. We had capped our budget to 1500 a night wherever we stayed. And I think we were able to find accommodations cheaper than that, which were surprisingly really good as well. So in no way we were very, very stingy about where we stayed. We had booked properties based on the budget, but we always kept the flexibility. If for example, the property did not turn out good when we arrived there, we were always open to cancelling and moving somewhere else. But fortunately, that really did not happen and we were pleasantly surprised. In terms of stay, the only place where we had very limited options out of all these locations, I think, was only Rameshwaram, which was, I think, it's maybe just because of the type of tourists that come there, which is predominantly for pilgrimage. And many of the hotels were really old and run down, so we couldn't find anything great. But that is one of the major reasons that we decided only to stay a night there and then travel to Kanyakumari the next day.
And we also got to experience homestays.
Of course. So the idea was to stay in a combination of Airbnbs as well as homestays. Airbnbs are wonderful, to be honest. The network is great, experiences and the community also is insightful. Wherever we stayed, we made it a point that we reviewed these places so that other people could also go there and stay. So I think Airbnb in terms of community and trust is something that you can go with. We couldn't find anything which was overly, you could say, price effective, but Airbnbs are more about experiences also, finding say a house very close to the sea or at an altitude, which you must have seen in videos at Fort Kochi. We were staying in a shared accommodation in which the house had a bedroom and an attached restroom which was given out, so that was great. The second Airbnb that we had chosen was the one in which we stayed in Munnar, which was a property right on top. And both these properties were really cost effective. It was just 800 a night at Fort Kochi. And if you've seen our video, please check out the video for Munnar, especially for the hotel.
Yeah.
It had a view of the entire valley and the tea plantations. It was just about 1400 rupees a night. Amazing place and really well managed and well maintained. So yeah, that's I think pretty much about stay as well as petrol. Complete budget for the 10 days for stay was around 12,200 rupees, and I think we ended up staying everywhere where we originally decided to book.
Yeah.
We did not cancel, and there were a lot of people who were helpful and flexible with, you could say, checkout timing, all of that. So that also worked in our favor.
Let's talk about food now. For food, I think we both wanted to explore and indulge as much as possible into the local cuisine, try out hotels or restaurants or cafes which are really famous or which we have heard they are worth going to. So mostly for food, we spent a lot in Pondicherry, in Kodaikanal and in Fort Kochi, because obviously the places that we went all along was the coastal side, so seafood was a little expensive more than the vegetarian dishes. But mainly in Pondicherry, Kodaikanal and Fort Kochi, there were a lot of cafes. They are really beautiful high-end cafes which we wanted to explore.
Yes.
And also for the main local cuisine that we spent on. And
to be honest, I think if you look at how much we have spent, if you just talk about whatever we have put in the Excel sheet, it's actually for two people.
Yeah.
So it is really not a lot of money. It is hardly on an average of spending about 15 to 1800 rupees to 2000 at the max,
right,
per day for breakfast, lunch and dinner. So I don't think it is excessively, you could say, in terms of spending.
Yeah.
But for me, I think I mentioned this to Momo as well, that we were hoping that the seafood would be really cheap when you go to these places, but that's really not
the
case.
It's
at par with what you would get in Bangalore also. But of course, the taste, the fresh catch, the experience is far, far superior.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't talk about it. But yeah, in terms of pricing, I think Pondicherry is at par with Bangalore in most senses, similar with Kochi also. So we were not really, I was a little surprised, but that's how it is.
Yeah.
But in no way I felt like we did not get our money's worth. I think that's the most critical thing.
Whatever places that we explored, any of the restaurants or cafes that we tried, it was worth it. The experience, the ambience, the food, the the way it was served, so all was worth it. And it came up to around 17,495 to be precise. And mainly our day-to-day routine was to have like a heavy breakfast and a light lunch and then a very light side of dinner. So all you can see that in our vlogs that we had a lot of food in between, so also during the course of the day, which was just snacks. So yeah, it was worth it. It's subjective to everyone, but this was our food indulgence throughout the 10 days. Now let's talk about miscellaneous. Miscellaneous was basically the tickets or any entry fees that is required, or the parking tickets, or mainly we had our bike washed in between. You can check out our vlog of the Kochi vlog, which we had our bike washed.
Yeah.
Then Kumarakam, we had a boat ride for 3 hours, which was another beautiful experience. So that was another cost. Then we hired a guide, which was in Mahabalipuram. We wanted to know more. We didn't know a lot about the history. So we wanted the guide to explain it to us. So these were some of the miscellaneous, expenditures that we made throughout the 10 days. That came up to around just roughly 2,800. So that's how overall we came up to 42,000. We were trying to maintain it till around.
So originally, I think our budget was 35.
Yeah.
That is how I saw it initially.
We planned
it. Then I think the only differential was the food. I originally calculated a par of 1500 all throughout, but then came all these wonderful cafes and restaurants serving so much of great food that we couldn't resist. And when you're there, I think you should just make the best of what you have in front of you. So that's what we did also. So
although the entire budget was 42,000, I think in no way we cut down on anything that we could not experience. We have experienced far more.
We never had the outlook of saying that, oh, this is too expensive, let's not do it. Yes, the only aspect of our trip where we had that outlook was, let's not spend too much on a hotel night, because we're not gonna spend a lot of time inside the hotel room. We are gonna be outside the entire day and just gonna sleep. So the only prerequisites, so
Wants to go for 4-star, 5-star hotels, it's up to you guys.
And it's the best time also. I think you're getting fantastic rates, and if you really want to stay in, say, better properties, you have really good deals. And I would always say that look for an experience with a stay closer to, you could say, the heart of the city where you have most of the experiences in and around. And don't say too detached, because that will discourage you from exploring. You might just stay in the hotel.
It
doesn't make sense for you to stay inside a hotel when Pondicherry is so beautiful outside.
But there are a lot of gorgeous, like really beautiful properties, hotels, and boutique hotels and resorts, which we also saw while we were walking throughout, like Kochi, Pondicherry, or say Kumarakam for that matter. Really
lot
beautiful.
A lot of experiences.
So yeah, you can try that too.
So I think all in all, this was our budget video. Sorry it's a little delayed. Yes, we did our trip in January and it's April. So by the time this video is out, it'll be first week of April. What we would do is we would share the Excel sheet with the links to our videos, where you can basically just have a look, refer to the experiences versus the amounts that we've spent.
Sure.
And we hope you get enough insights to plan your next trip.
Just a cute little guideline for you, how you can plan your 10 days.
Absolutely. And
any tour that we want to plan.
We'll be open to taking any questions that you might have. We have contact information of people who were really kind to us, who actually were very hospitable also. So all in all, I think if you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel, Bruce Mums. And we again wanted to say thank you for all the love and support that you've given us.
True.
And we would have a couple of more videos which will come out along with this, which is what's in our bag. So you can check out that. Because yes, the $1 million question was, how did you manage to pack all this up for 10 days? And we also have our trip to Pune, which was phenomenal. We traveled from Bangalore to Pune, which was about 860 kilometers in flat, 13 hours.
So super. Stay tuned, check out all those videos, and for now we are gonna end this vlog by saying
peace out,
Bones.